Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this tutorial, we are going to discuss about star topology. Now first let us see the architecture of the star topology. Okay, this is the architecture of star topology. There will be a central hub, and to that hub all the devices will be connected. This is device 1, this is device 2, and this is device n. Okay, so if this device wants to transfer the information to these devices, to remaining devices, it cannot directly transfer because there is no direct connection to this device to another devices. Okay, so then what is the case is this device will first transfer the information to the hub, and this hub will check to what device this device 1 wanted to transfer the information. See, if this device wanted to transfer information to device 2, first it will transfer to hub, and from hub the hub will transfer the same information to device 2. Thus the information will be reaching from device 1 to device 2. This is the working form of star topology. Okay, now let us see the advantages and disadvantages of the star topology architecture. Coming to advantages, it requires less cost, means we can construct or we can buy the star topology with less cost. It is cost effective, it is less expensive. Okay, second advantage is central hub is the second advantage, because all the information will stored here. Okay, we should transfer here from the central hub will take the responsibility to transfer the image to the destination. So central hub is one of the advantage. Okay, and third advantage is less cabling. I will explain you what is less cabling, but before understanding the concept of less cabling, you should watch out my previous video, which is on mesh topology. Okay, because this is the advantage which came out from the disadvantage of the mesh topology. So in order to understand this particular point, watch out my previous video on mesh topology. Okay, now I'll explain you less cabling means the previous topology, that is the star topology, second kind of topology. The first kind of topology is mesh topology. In mesh topology, the architecture will be like this. This is one device, this is one device, this is one device, and this is one device, and this is another device. Okay, this device will be connected to this, this device will be connected to this, like this, with a form of links. Okay, see, in order to establish a connection from 1 to 2, this link should be laid out. Link is nothing but wiring. Okay, wires, internal wires should be laid out. Same here, same here, same here, and same here. See, there is lot of wires in the mesh topology. Okay, means it requires more storage. So we came out with the concept of the star topology. In star topology, there is an advantage of less cabling. Less cabling means, see the architecture here, there is a hub. Okay, hub is the central device which is connected to all the devices. Okay, so there is no requirement of wiring. Okay, there is no requirement or less requirement of wiring, so it saves a lot of memory storage. These are the advantages of the star topology. Now let us see what are the disadvantages of star topology. Okay, let's start. Coming to the disadvantages of the star topology, one disadvantage is dependency. Dependency means, I will explain you now. See, we already came to know that if device 1 wants to transfer the information to device 2 or device n or any other device, it should first transfer the information to the hub. Hub will take the responsibility of sending that information to the final destination. Okay, so this is the concept of the star topology. But if the star topology, if the hub in star topology failed working, if there is any problem with the hub, then though it transfers the information to the hub, it cannot work properly and it cannot send the final information to the destination. So this is one of the advantage. And second advantage is we have the concept here as each node must be linked to central hub, so there may be traffic. See, I will explain you. All the devices will be sending the information to the hub. So here there may be occurrence of traffic. These are the disadvantages and advantages of the star topology. That's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Hope you understood the video and found it helpful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such videos. Thank you.